Welcome back, everyone, to Mage Wars. Not in the game yet. We are looking at a beautiful picture of a nice young lady from the forest. She's a druid. And today we are trying something that everyone talks about, but no one really does because it's kind of niche, but it's fun, and it's called the Samara Tree. So this is the Seedling parts with an exclamation mark deck that I have made. It's my attempt at making the Samara Tree work. So how do we do that? We have Samara Tree and I think five seedling pots. And we are comboing that with the vine tree. So we're putting out the vine tree first, I think. I want it to be life bonded with the Samara Tree. And I think that I'm doing that. We're going to do that because I think the vine tree is still more important for the strategy as a whole, that you can it can do more of our stuff, so it's more valuable than the Samara tree. If none of them are bonded, the vine tree is still better. So we're bonding with the Samara tree because then if we lose the Samara tree, the bonded tree, we do lose the bonus, but we still have the vine tree. And if they go for the vine tree, well, we still have the Samara tree, the bonded tree. So kind of taking some heat off our power wine tree that has been burned so many times, and we're trying to tank it out with the Samara tree. Also Ethereum life tree, lots of trees. Well, three trees only, it seems. We don't have Mokhtari in here. What can we deploy from the seedling pods? I have gone for lots of tangle wines. I want to keep the enemy away, and some strangle wines to go with that. I think also if an enemy creature moves into a zone with a seedling pod, you can, if it survives the initial attack, you can put a strangle wine on someone all of a sudden. That could be a cool strat. So lots of plans in general just to deploy from wines. Maximum of the Thorn Lasher and the Wine Snapper. Two Raptor Wines to beef it up a bit. Cradlethor I think is really good. Good zombie counter as well. And Tatori is good for supporting plants, both with the healing, and she can put mana on plant objects, which is of course the tree, as you may have seen people do, but they can also go on the seedling pods, of course. And the thing with them is that they need 3 mana. So if you want something quicker from a seedling pod, then you can put extra mana on them with Tatori. Now if only she wasn't legendary, and you can have 6 of her, just imagine. Anyway, moving on. Astral Anger, I don't really know about that one, but we can combo that with the Tank Wines, and we can try to have the enemies restrained to one zone. I want to make one big kill zone. Blur is good for staying at a distance with all their restraint and stuff. We can move into range 2 while the enemy is restrained, and then some good enchantments to defend the mage. Major bark skin, of course, and I think one jinx is good. Maybe we should go more, but I don't know. We will definitely have an action advantage with this deck, and jinx helps you cancel out other actions, enemy actions, for your own actions, and so they are action gaining. What am I trying to say? If you have more, then denying them one for one is advantageous to you. Usually. So elemental wand, just one of those to go with the force hammer that I've chosen as the only attack spell. We are going to have that on elemental wand for sure. So I wanted to do that for destroying certain conjurations. Deathlock or druid trees are also fine to destroy with it. And then of course the Mind's Eye can be used for that as well. We have one veteran's belt to go, just because we'll have a lot of regen as is, and with the rhino hide and bark skin you have 4 armor. That's decent, and you can sometimes get rid of that and then reapply it, and corrodes fall off, so that's a way to deal with that. Veteran's belt is for getting swarmed. You just have a bit more. Well, it's 3 spellbook points, so maybe we shouldn't have it. Anyway, to move the enchantments around a bit. Again, I'm thinking Astral Angle will probably go down, but I don't know. We can move some enchantments around, it's cheap. Force Push, just one. Some basic removal, only one to solve, but we do have some. And I lost the art for my teleport. I don't really know. Apparently if you click this little button up here, don't ever click this button. Because I hit that by accident and now my teleport is gone. Yeah, and if anyone knows how I get my teleport back, please let me know. I don't know. Anyway, that's the druid. The Samara druid. Sorry, the seedling pods, exclamation mark. Druid. We do have the corrosive organ. We only have two. Some wall thorns. Lots of spine walls. And I put in the pillar of righteous flame just because. It's a good spell. And you can hold people in the zone with tangle wines. Alright, I will, I'll see you on the battlefield. Okay, and here we are in the game versus Poopstar. He has gone with the Araxian Crown Warlock, and I'm trying to get the... I'm not sure what the opening should be in this case. I'm gonna try opening with the Vine Tree and not bond with it. That's kind of my idea. Not sure that's gonna work. We're gonna move and Tattery. And he went for a mana crystal. So let's see where what he quick casts. Could be a Battleforge. A Battle Forge. So I probably want the Samara Tree up front, even though it's the better, more important tree, but we can wall here and it's gonna be easier to block, so that might be a thing. Just see if he doesn't think that I missed it. Then comes Samara Tree, I think. And probably we could do a Tangle Wine. Or we could do a Seedling Pod. Might be too early to go for it. It's gonna up our channeling a bit. We could throw more seedling pots. I would want a thorn lasher early, so maybe a seedling pot in this area could be good. I could throw in from the mage. Will I have enough? I will. Huh. But a closed enchantment on the mage could be good as well. A closed enchantment on the mage could be Barkskin, of course. Yeah, let's try it. I'm ready to wall off here if we needed. I'll probably just put a seedling pod in this zone. Ployman, that's me. So by now he probably knows that the Samara Tree might be coming. Which is cool. We'll see how he reacts. I'm not gonna enchant anything. I could have quick cast it on myself. Actions, I'll move this thing away. I don't want it to die unnecessarily. Wine tree done. Action marker. What am I looking for? Did I say done? No. Okay. He went for Enchanter's Ring for his deploy. So here's a creature. Okay, so he's going brute. And could be an enchantment transfuse from the mage. With curses. Done with the actions phases, so I can do whatever. Put it here still. I could actually have deployed a pod up here instead, that would have been better. But this is fine. And like that. And we are good. Could put out two more seedling pods this round. I think one is fine though. From here. We could pay for an extra wine marker, that would probably be a good idea. Oh, I didn't add the Meridius Blessing to this book. Did I? I forgot that one. Well, we're gonna make a mental note about that. A thorn lasher would be nice. Although it's a living creature, which benefits you. Still probably want to do it. I want a seedling pod here, I think. So then where does the thorn lasher go? I can make wine, and then Seedling Pod, Thorn Lasher. Let's go for a Nullify. Oh, and a Blur would be good. Yeah, so we're supposed to Tangle Wine him. We can't really do that in the first phase, but I could move and Tangle Wine. I can quick cast Tangle Wine, of course. I could start with that. Just delay. We'll see what he does. Maybe he double moves, though. That would be kind of bad. So let's aim for the Tangle Wine. I'm not gonna do the Thorn Lasher this round. And so he's gonna deploy something also. He has 13 mana, I have 12, but I'm making a lot more than he is right now. He's also making one for the ring, of course. I could use that to make wines if I wanted. Okay, so he's also going kind of long game with that. Done with the deployment. I will go like this and like this, then remove that. not that one. That's how you do it. And then paste the mana from there. All good. Cast the Tangle Wine on him. Hopefully that will absorb some actions. I could go Force Hammer Wand and destroy his forge. That's Mageddon, okay. Star is done. You can move. Put a mana on this thing. Yeah, let's do that. And I can move away probably and cast the Nullify. So now the Tangle Wine will be occupying the Zombie Brood for a while. It's gonna take it down by itself. And I will move away. Cast that Nullify. I could move closer as well. How many dissolves do I have? One dissolve. And two corrosive orchids. Let's start out with this. I mean that amulet is gonna last for a while. Done with the actions phases. Final quick cast. Okay. The enchanted Mageddon. So Mageddon is an interesting choice. It's gonna take it a while before it's able to get to my area here, and that means I will be allowed to build up a lot more. We will put down more seedling pots, of course. None of them can deploy yet. And I kind of feel like I would want to strangle wine the... Oh, he could still teleport. I guess we want to drain those teleports as early as possible anyway. He also has no armor, so I kind of could throw him through a wall of thorns. I want a seedling pot in here for sure. So what do we cast? It's the one of Thorn Lasher here too. That's three mana there. Or we could make the seedling pot in here for that. And then I don't really know. A Rat to Wine early could be really good as well. Maybe just two seedling pots, honestly. It's gonna take too long. Oh, Krellothor. Now, yeah, Krellothor. We are making a Krellothor pod. green ceiling pod. That's what I'm trying to say. Okay, I like that. Make him spend that teleport. And we will start building up with even more seedling pods. Yeah, I'll make one. Is that the last one? Wow. Yeah, that's cool. I don't want it in hand, I want it there. And I could go blur, so he can't touch me. Or let's just go bear strength. Nah, we'll go blur. Right now it seems I can stay on a long range for a while. So I'm starting. I'm putting one there, then one here that I will be using for a ceiling pot from here. This one is basically free. Where do I want it? If it's gonna be Krylothor, it might as well go here. I'm not gonna be able to cast a ceiling far, I say ceiling pod next turn. No. Let's put it here. Let's see if he attacks it. I wanna know. Okay, so yeah, it's only 3 mana. Should be okay. I might have need to have more ceiling parts in the deck, after all. First quick cast, I'm not gonna quick cast. I'll be waiting till they have all spent their actions, and then I will strangle wine the zombie brood. I'm gonna move you here. Actions phase. Done. Just done. Five. Oh, that's enough to kill it. So I might just move and strangle wind him instead. See what he does. I'm saving the mana for the nullifier right now. But if we go to the quick cast phase without him moving, we will cast the blur. Okay, so he shouldn't just one-shot it, I think. Oh, but he did. That's unfortunate. I want to write like a sad smiley face, but that's not. Okay, do I want to have blur now? It's going to be his initiative, but I suppose I'll whine and then tangle whine. Yeah, I should do that. Now we are not going to reveal, because I can reveal in the deployment phase next round, so he might prep something that he thinks he can hit with me with, and then Hopefully we will take away that option. Final quick cast. I gotta remember that he probably has an arcane corruption. So we don't want to have too many enchantments stacking. Might be better to put the rhino hides on the two raptor wines. Maybe same with bear strength. So this one here could be the Krellothor pod, actually. I think I want to do mana flower here, so I get one seedling pod back. And we're going to deploy a tank of wine. So that's three and then two. So I have five for this round. That's not a lot. Ah, the forge. I didn't do anything about the forge. I can't afford the corrosive ore kit. He could do a flame whip. He has a lot of mana. If he does a flame whip, do we have a problem? Probably. It's his initiative, so if he flame whips, I won't tank a wine. And then instead, we can prep. Mage wand? Maybe. I could even go Pillar of Righteous Flame. Are we gonna have more mana going forward? That's a good, good thing to remember, because right now it's not looking too swell. Jinx could be interesting. Let's go for a veteran spell. Interesting. I don't really know. Still equipped the tank of wine. Okay, I'm gonna choose something now. Maybe that's two wands. It's probably okay. Most likely I will get to melee something this turn instead. Which I think is fine. It's okay to tank a little bit with the mage in the beginning here, but they are some tough creatures that he has have out now, and so far all my stuff does not roll any dice. I only have four dice on the field, whereas he has more. I might want to reconsider. I still want that. Do I want like a thorn lasher here or a wine snapper maybe? No, I can't deploy from these, but I could deploy from the tree. You know what? I could prepare it on the mage. I could totally do that. So a thorn lasher. Probably a wine snapper. So Krellothor is here in theory. That's what I'm going for. Which is why I would want to melee something this round, if possible. Deployment phase. Yeah, okay, so that doesn't work against the Tanglewine. He has one seal token left. So I may want to go here, here, mana, and then just still do that maybe? Now we want to deploy this. And that would be 3. I think that's okay. Since the wand cannot have anything that targets the Tanglewine. Oh, and then blur. Oh, and now I can't afford a mage one, is that right? I must have miscounted that. Huh. So I'm not going to be casting any spells. I shouldn't have revealed blur then. I might have wanted to move in closer instead. Yeah, but if I had the mage wand, I could move, put it on the mage wand, and then dissolve first action next turn. But I haven't checked for a nullify on him, which is something we could also do with the wand, I suppose. Inflict 3 damage on Tanglewine. Sure. Let's put a mana on that. So I'll be honest, it's not going too well. This is looking really dangerous, and the mage is getting stronger each round. I'm not really getting anything yet. We're still buying time with the Tanglewines. It's gonna be the last Tanglewine, I think, because I can't keep doing that. We might want to put out the Aetherian Life Tree as soon as possible. I can't deploy it from a seedling pod because of the way I've positioned them. Not with the actions phases, so me. But I don't want to get hit. That's the thing. Because then I have to pay for blur. Yeah. So we don't really have the, what would I call it? The potential to optimize our position here, because I don't have the mana to both do this build up and... But I was, I guess I was assuming that we would be in some sort of melee with the mages beforehand. Hand of Imshila. Okay, I could melee that. That will be really good to get rid of. He hasn't taken any damage yet, though. Oh yeah, he got the strength 1 and 1 hit. That was unfortunate. Would have liked to pressure him a bit more. Yeah, I shouldn't have revealed the blur. I should probably have had a... Oh, we do have some armor in the bark skin, I suppose. So we can get credit for now if I want, but then I don't get anything else. If I build the Ethereum life tree, I could do that here or here. Taking over this area seems fine. Still can't deploy from these two seedling pots. We are gonna do one of them from next round. Now a thorn lasher in there would be pretty good, because it can start tickling the hand of imps alive, nothing else. So that's 5 and 7. I like that. Let's put this back. And then finally get the rhino hide, probably. Maybe damage on the mage. And I do have the shift enchantment. He only has 2 spells. I think an enchantment is in order. Oh, we could jinx him. That might be the right call. Do the whole action denial thing. I'm making considerably more mana than he is. Well, I'll count it in a minute. No. Oh. Did I want anything else? No. So we'll do that. Will we do that? Do I even need any more zone exclusives like that? I don't really. Let's put it here. No, wait, they can't. We could do it there. Let's do that. See if he uses an action to hit it. Can't really have more. This is only the only zones that I would need one, I think. So I think this is fine. Is that all my deployment then? No, because then I also want this one to go here. And he put down, sorry, the demon hide mask, which doesn't really help against my plans with the demon thing, at least. First quick cast. I will probably just jinx him. We'll see if he has a nullify that way. More jinxes could be good. Maybe instead of double astral anchor, so double jinx. I'll consider that. So am I. The actions I will move. I think I want the Ethereum tree up there. Whoops. Let's click. See if he fireballs that. I'm not sure I'm gonna win this whole attrition war, because he is gaining life. He now has two strong creatures on the board, so he will probably kill my stuff faster than I kill his. 36. Notably, this also gave McGeddon two extra health, of course. He might have Deathlock in the book. That would be interesting. More creatures. Makes sense. And a Dark Pact Slayer comes out. We're looking at a juicy Righteous Flame at some point. And then a Blood Reaver on that. I've got to do. Yeah, done. I will. Mana on Wine Tree. I've done it. Let's just. I should probably start boosting this thing, but he could snipe it, of course, if I build it up too much. He got the tank of wine, even though it has extra health. That was a good roll. And a rouse on the Dark Pact Slayer here. And now it's all gonna fall apart. It does survive that, the one seedling pod. Of the Ethereum life tree. But it will probably not survive the Dark Pact Slayer. No, because we are going to put it in the book. I don't have anything. Let's go. So now, the horde is coming. Are we ready? No. My stuff is pretty beefy and, you know, regenerating. I'm gonna put up a wall here, most likely. Right? That makes sense. I can even deploy it from that. And then we want a Wine Snapper in here. If it goes for the Ethereum Life Tree, I'm not too sad. That's a ways around to my Bonded Tree. And I will likely be meleeing with the Mage this turn. I didn't get the Bear Strength Honor, but I could consider that. So we do want this on something. Could be here. And then I could put one in hand in case he just destroys the first one. And we want a Wine Snapper. It's gonna cost us 5, and this is 1, so that's 6. I have 5. Can do a second one of those, or a Bear Strength and hit. is not gonna work out, I think. Well, the Mimbridius blessing would have been really good here. Also, just for healing the tank wines while he was in them there. So, that's definitely something I want to reconsider in this deck. Change the planning phase. Yep. And actually, I should put a seedling pod on Samara Tree just to bluff every time. Yo. Yo and T. Deployment. He's putting on gloves. I will put up the wine wall. I had to do that, I didn't see. So that's a problem, because now I can't really... If I can still do both and then not reveal the bear strength, I suppose. Okay, why is it not a spend action marker? Boom, 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 is everything ready? I think it is. Done with deployment. First quick cast. I think he just has too much damage on the board at the moment. This is maybe a bear strength even. And it's just gonna... they're just gonna plow through and trash my stuff. Maybe I can deploy stuff fast enough that we can stand a chance. The blur did not help. First quick cast. Yeah, I'm done too. So I'm excited to see what he will do. He's quick casting. And he is gonna try to shoot down the wall before we go through it. Firestream. Good basic fire spell there. Six dice, it's not gonna be enough. Right, because it has eight. So the Ethereum Light Tree working out well for me at the most, at least. So it's gonna add... At this point it's basically paid for itself, because he's spending additional actions to kill stuff that he would have to have one-shotted. So that's really nice. He can still move and destroy it, and then I will quick cast my own and pull his activated creature through, hopefully, and that will probably be the mage at this point. Some things targeted. Oh, he's gonna hit it with the zombie. Probably a better choice, yeah. I agree. One damage is not enough. Interesting. So I can pull stuff through it now. We could go for the brood. If I go for anything else, it can just move and attack something down here instead. If so, it would go for... He didn't take any damage, so the Blood Reaver's not gonna help him much. And I do want that thing to die fast. run out of walls really quick. I see. Ah, oh, that's a bad roll. Oh man, not good. I think I will not put up this second wall, because I do want to move and melee something anyway. Start tanking with the mage. He's done with that. I will just put mana on. I'll put it on this one. Because I want to have Kralathor out next round, probably. I don't know if it's a good choice, but it's. We could put out a Raptor Wine, very cheap. So, done. I don't know if I'm gonna deploy anything from the wine tree, really. This one was probably a mistake, because by the time that this grows into a wine snapper, the forge will pretty much have lived out its usefulness. 4 damage on Bloodspine Wall. Yes. I accept. And I can move on guard. Ah, but he can ignore guards with that one. Well, then I'm guarding the other creatures at least, and we got him into the zone. I actually think that might tempt him to go here just because he's elusive and he can do it. let's hope so. And I'm gonna enchant the mage. I could hit the mage and try to destroy Blur. I'm probably just gonna have to let Blur go. Done with the actions phases, yeah. Well, he's still in range 2 of me at the moment, so he can't quick cast on me in the next round. So probably I could go with not destroying Blur just once. I do need the mana. I really do. I'm gonna be at 13 plus 6. That's 19. It's enough for Kralathor and the reveal of Bear Strength. Running Link, yeah. And he gave it melee plus 1 probably. Oh. So he's attacking the... No, okay, he's still going for the mage. That's cool. No. I'm gonna say no for that one right now. It's not too much damage. Yes or no? No. We can't. I have to go aggressive with the mage now. And nice, 2 damage. Good start. Yeah, it's not gonna be an easy fight, this one. That's for sure. We can sleep one of his living creatures. That's nice. I probably want a seedling pod in this zone from the tree. That's the melee token, I suppose. Okay. I'll make a note. Mm. Okay. We want something on that. Is Kralithor a good option? I'd say no. Probably a rat wine, because I need mana for other stuff than one beefy creature that's probably gonna get sniped hard. This takes mana to move around. Just one more. So it's 7 mana difference, but we're gonna have to move it at least one, so 6 mana difference. If I deploy this, I will have 7 mana there. I'll have 4 mana left. That's enough for a seedling pot here and reveal of bear strength and then nothing else. But then not the nullify. We are gonna go for the raptor wine, because I need mana for my reveals, otherwise they're not worth anything. Probably want the Bloodspine Wall. I will put something on the Samara Tree, I should either way. And I can force push something out. I could force push this through the wall before it moves. Wait a minute. This one, then that's 3, 1, that's 4, 2, that's 6. Move and force push is 8. Damn. So not the seedling pod. But then no nullify, so it's not gonna work. And I wanna melee anyway, so maybe but I could go for this. That's 2 and 3, that's 5. That's too much. Damn. What, the pillar? Here. After the zombie brood moves in. Maybe next turn? Pillar next turn. Pillar next turn. Wanna dissolve as well. I could probably put that in hand as an option. If I get the move and the dissolve in this wand, that would be really good. Right, he didn't put a new spell on himself. Okay, so that's probably gonna be the first priority. Maybe not. It's not gonna be able to melee then. I could move melee and then do that here. So the Bloodspine Wall is maybe not the right choice at all. This thing could be the right choice in here. Even though it doesn't do the sleep thing, it could be useful. This is 5. 2 and 3, 5. I don't want something that's more than 5 then. That's 7. I don't know. I do like that. In here. So that's 5, 6. It's even more expensive. So what am I thinking? 6 and 2 is 8. So perfect for the dissolve, not for the pillar. Pillar next turn. Pillar next turn. I'm being indecisive here, sorry. I will put this. What am I gonna do against that? Damn. Arcane Corruption. That's what I'm thinking. that's a problem too. He does have a lot of cool equipment that I kind of would want to remove. So I might want it on a mage wand after all. Because that's my only dissolve. Which is kind of a bad play on me. They are so cheap. I should get more. That's not all I wanted to do, I think. Oh, I forgot to regen. Let's not do it now. That's really stupid. I should have remembered that. Actions phase. So I'm gonna remove that wand because I do want that gone. But the sword is probably worse in a sense. Yeah, the sword is probably worse, even. And I'm gonna just melee that thing. Did that take it out? I don't think it did. No, not quite. Oh. Well, that's silly. Yeah, I don't have enough mana to do all the things that I want. That's the problem with spawn points, you want to do all the things so that they pay themselves back, right? But then they never get to do that because I don't have enough mana to support it. I've still got stuff coming onto the board a lot faster than he does, so maybe we can stay afloat for long enough that I will just kill some of his creatures and we can live happily ever after, something like that. I might want to tickle that with the Thorn Lasher. That's going to remove some of his advantage anyway, right? Coming for the mage, of course. Ow. He's rolling 7? Hmm. And I didn't get it to remove anything, so that's... Yeah, I didn't play this too well. I was trying something with that whole tank of wine thing. It didn't really work out. And I spent my quick cast even though I didn't have to. So obviously not on top of my game tonight. Can't be that every night. It's my turn. I'm just rambling and it's my turn. Okay, I'm gonna try to focus a bit more here. I guess I kind of want to pull someone to the Wine Snapper now, right? Oh, so that would be him. Let's actually just put mana with this thing. It can heal, though. That might be better right now, just to heal something. Let's pull Mageddon back and away from the mage, by the way. That's also going to be threatening Mageddon at least, so now that they have to think maybe to support him here. Oh, of course not, because he didn't get pulled. So never mind. I Things are not going my way. I'm at 12 damage. Wow, that was a good hit. It was 7 damage, so it's not too unlikely for it to be 8, I suppose. Could have revealed Bard Skin, but then we wouldn't have enough for the Nullify, and I'm expecting a curse at some point. He's gonna move and attack me, of course. He's got 5. Oh, he's got the gloves, yeah. Is it time for Barkskin? I think it is, because he's gonna roll more dice against me now. So now we hope he doesn't have a curse in hand, because that would be really bad. 4 damage and do divine. Yep. Oh, he's got piercing. Oh, for the mask, of course. But the 2 armor is going to work against the scimitar, at least. And the Weinsnarber is going to end up doing nothing this round. Go ahead, dude. That's 3 extra dice. Oh. And 2 damage, 2 crit. Yep. No, it's auto. Good. I will put mana on. I guess the wine tree is best. Right now. So now he's probably gonna move somewhere not where the white never is. He can just attack a seedling pod here, for example. And it is gonna kill it, right? No, that's not enough. Very nice. Again, the Aetherian life tree coming in, saving me. And we can. There we go. And it can guard, of course. Teleport. And somehow I deleted my image for a teleport. Yeah. I don't know how to get it back. So I'll look into it, don't worry. Demonic Bloodlust teleport. Okay, so he's going for face completely. Good choice, I think. And he is going to be able to overwhelm me easily. Actually, a Pillar of Righteous Flame would have been really good this turn. Final quick cast. Well, I can't really do anything. It might be too late to pillar though. Even though I pillar, he'll just move in the creatures and try to get him hit on the mage. I can be all slippery like and teleport here, then double move to the corner. Might be a good thing to do. It's gonna be his initiative, I suppose. Yeah, I think it was mine this round. It probably just didn't flip the marker yet. Currently have one seedling pod on the board. I guess we will pay for our barkskin, yes. There we go. Was I looking for? Alright, the initiative. Yep. It is his initiative. So bad. Bad place by Keishin here. Not good. Can we save this? Can we try figure out a solution. It's gonna be his initiative. I'm gonna heal two more. Gonna remember the life bond this time. I do have like 15 hit points, so I'm not dead yet. Still have a nullify on us. We could probably go for rhino hide, and then I would like to dissolve, obviously, but I think there are more. There are other concerns that I should take note of. Oh, teleport! But he's gonna prep a teleport, but I have a nullify. I only have one big teleport, that's the thing, and I would want it on a mage wand, ideally. We could tank wind the mage, and then do the lesser teleport and move. Double move. Okay, of course you can just destroy the tangle wine. But I do have a pretty good zone here. We can move and put up a wall of thorns. That would delay a little bit. I could throw him through a wall of thorns. He doesn't have any armor on. That's hilarious, but I don't have the mana for it. But I will put it up, and maybe we can push him through it next turn. That would be cool. I don't know. Let's see. I do have bear strength, that's awesome. But not really that useful. We will deploy a seedling pod, I suppose. No reason not to. We can deploy something here. But I would rather the brute just hit it again. That's fine. It's regenerating. Fantastic. Let's let it be and see if it survives. And we're gonna put one in here. This one will have to move. That's one mana. We're not gonna be spending a lot of mana. Rhino and Wall of Thorns would be 7, which I think is more than we have. No, that would be okay. Yeah, so I'm gonna do this. It's bluffing. And I will not put anything on here, of course, because then it would be destroyed. So, I'm actually not sure it would be destroyed. I mean, the seedling pod doesn't get destroyed. Ah, that's probably not how it works. Why did you get the cancer traits? I don't know. And he put on armor now. That's a wise choice. Even though I couldn't Wall of Thorns push, but you never know. I will put in a seedling pod. Ha! Huh. It'll cost me 1 mana to put it here. That's fine though. Wait, maybe not. Maybe not. I do have a wine there. Okay, so not deploying that wine. We can just do a wine from here and then a seedling pod. And it was free, right? First quick cast. Oh, he'll do a tank of wine on me and then I'm gonna get ruined. Because I didn't think of that. Ha! That's a tank of wine. Oh, a wall. Okay. I can still get out then. That's interesting. I will. Should I quick cast? I suppose. It's good for pretending I've got something I want to do. Like something to counter, might make him a bit more careful before hitting. You know, it could be a reverse attack or something. So that's good. And then when I get the chance, I move and put up the wall. I still have my nullify, so he can't mess around too much. We might get out of this. I'm still healing 4 per round, which is kind of silly, but awesome. Silly awesome. he's going... No, he's got to be going for Mage. The Bluff First, he doesn't apply to conjurations, so he... Yep, he can just move. And I cannot afford to reveal Rhino Hide, sadly. So that was pretty intense. Rolling 8 with 6. Yeah. So now the ballsy thing would be to move here and cast the wall here. Safe thing is here, because then at least the rat wine can come and support. And it's gonna be in range of a lot more stuff. We can still deploy here next turn, which could be another wall of thorns, honestly. Is that right? That could be really fun. Let's use this seedling part for something. Of course, he's gonna knock down the wall pretty easily, but it's gonna soak some attacks. And then next turn I will have initiative. I can teleport in the quick cast if I want to just go here. Something like that. I will attack the wall, because it gives me access to the Hand of Bimshalaf with the Thorn Lasher. I don't know, maybe I should keep it. That was a good roll though, so it's almost dead. But again, the Aetherian Life Tree, keeping it alive, just one more action. That was... Oh, so the Flying Slash. Okay, so that's the sword attacking, of course. Yeah, he's rolling a lot of dice with that as well. Which is bad for me. This is 12, this is 5, attack dice, 5, and then 3. So I could open up, potentially. It would take them all a turn. And these two will get to hit me, which I'm not gonna lie, that's gonna suck real bad. I don't think I can really feasibly do anything to stop it, so I'll just I'll do this. The poison thing here doesn't work on the wall of bones, of course. And it's a below average roll, so not good. I can still not afford to reveal the rhino, sadly. Now, if I don't die here, I can teleport to this zone here and then, you know, put down the Renewing Spring even and just drop. But look at that, wow. Yeah, I'm not gonna live. I'm dead. Ouch. Well, he got me there. Really got me there. Interesting game, my friend. It was. I enjoyed it. I want the Samara Tree to work, you know, but I could have played this a bit better. My dwarves were below. I did not see your book, Poopstar. I'll check it out. That's cool. Maybe we can, maybe I'll post it at the end here. Oh, could that be fun? I don't know. And here we go. He revealed his hand, so we'll just take a look here, just real quick. I want to try to do some more spotlights on my opponents. I know I tend to focus more on my own, but it's always interesting to see what other players are doing. I think this is a pretty good selection of skimming through it. I love Siphon Life, definitely, and Drain Life, yeah, cool. Good selection of attack spells, definitely. Not so many conjurations and creatures. I see he had more walls, but he only needs that really when... okay, so other than that, it looks pretty. It's a good amount of curses, but not too. You don't see any doubles, meaning he's not going for. I just one enchantment transfusion, which is good with curses. I really agree. It's a good one too. Boom, boom. What else? Oh, it looks good. Good selection of attack spells here, but he does have a. Only a single elemental wand, okay. Okay, so following the battle that we just were in, I want to try something new. Because my decks will... After every game, I usually go into the spellbook builder and go and readjust my spellbooks based on the game that I was just in. So for this one, for example, we would, based on my notes that I made mentally, we will put that one down. Maybe blur. No, I don't know. What was it else? What else was it? We wanted more dissolves for sure. I was also considering overrides. So let's not waste any time and go get Meridia's blessing, because I think that would have helped a lot in that game. We need the Renewing Spring. I guess I'll keep it for now. Oh, it's for moving conditions as well, and it's sort of in school. I like that. We have Elemental Wand and Mage Wand. I still think that's okay. Now, was there anything else that I really needed? Okay, let's try and validate that. Okay, so that's one above. We could get rid of the Veteran's build, and for 3 spellbook points, I can get another Rhino Hide. Another Bear Strength if I want. Stuff like that. Another Jinx. Another Nullify. Another Dissolve. Okay, you know what? I think that kind of clears it up. We need a Rhino Hide, I think, for our creatures. The 2 Retrowinds and our Mage, maybe? Or one for Kralothor if he comes out. Do we need to think in other stuff that are cheaper? We could go Leather. I could go Gate of Toughness. But stacking so many enchantments, you need to consider it enchantment transfusion and Purge Magic and stuff like that. I don't really have anything for that kind of stuff yet. So maybe. I still want a Mage Wand, or maybe one more to solve, but I did want to go at range, so maybe instead let's see, I should still have 2, but I'm going to go one more Corrosive Orchid, I think. Do we want to swap one Wall of Thorns for Bloodspine Wall? Probably. Up and down, up and down. We can see through that. Really, our mage should have blur. That's the thing. So, a meditation amulet could be interesting. As a matter of fact, that's an interesting proposition. What are we at? 21, so we need 3 points. Which I think we were all already kind of scratching. I was suggested by the man I played against. What was his name? Poopstar. To go down on ceiling parts, we will do that. I think that's I can see that. I could see that. Maybe the Nightshade Lotus is honestly not that good, because I never get it to work. I never get it to work. But you can have one in the same zone as a Corrosive Orchid. That's the thing. You can't have two Corrosive Orchids in the same zone. So how are we looking now? Now we're even. So we'd have to go. What would we do then? I think the Astral Anchor is not doing much for me, because I kind of want them to teleport away and, you know, spend their teleports. That's usually what will happen. We can just add more Tangle Wines if. But we have so many Tangle Wines, and I have the Wine Wave staff to keep people restrained, and I should really try using that next time. That's what it's there for. Okay. And then I go Meditation Amulet. So the deck is now evolving a bit, and next time you see me play it, hopefully I will not have adjusted too much and you can see me play it again. So that was nice for a little let's call it after game meditation. And thank you for watching, everyone. Bye bye.